In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, amen. The Gospel today from the Gospel according to St. Luke, chapter 7, from verse 36 to verse 50. It is about the invitation of one of the Pharisees to our Lord Jesus Christ to eat with him in his house, and about the sinful woman who grabbed the chance and offered her repentance, and the Lord accepted her repentance and she went in peace. The summary of this wonderful story is someone, his name is Simon, the Pharisee, invited our Lord Jesus Christ to eat with him in his house. And a sinful woman in the city heard about that, and she heard a lot about our Lord Jesus Christ. She went and offered her repentance in a very unique way. But Simon in his heart said, how can, they said, he is a prophet. If he is a prophet, he will know who she is. She is a sinner. And the Lord Jesus Christ proved to him that he can know what he is in his mind and in his heart, and give him wonderful parable or illustration about the story or the situation. And then the Lord revealed that he accepted her repentance. We are not sure why the Pharisee or one of the Pharisees would make such an invitation, since most of them, they are in full disagreement with our Lord Jesus Christ in his teaching and in his ministry. But one of our early church fathers said, most likely, Simon was testing our Lord Jesus Christ to find some fault or accusation against him. Imagine the outside story that he invited him in his house to eat with him. It's a wonderful invitation. But deep inside, he would like to hold anything against him because they don't like his teaching and they don't like his ministry. And St. Luke recorded for us very carefully that Simon did not have to wait long until he found what he looked for. As we know that the certain woman entered, and it seemed she had a very bad reputation in the entire city, and everyone knew that she is a sinner. And she entered and she offered her repentance in a very unique way. She kissed our Lord Jesus' feet, wiped his feet with her tears, and wiped it with her hair. And then she put a very expensive perfume in his head. So it is amazing what she did to express the sincerity of her repentance. And Simon looked at this and added to this worst in his mind, that Jesus Christ did not rebuke the woman, he did not send her away, he let her touch him. So all this come in his mind, and St. Luke recorded very carefully that he said in his heart. This is mean that he did not talk, or nobody heard what inside his heart, except our Lord Jesus Christ. In his heart, he said to himself, if this really a prophet, he will know who is she and who is touch him, she is a sinner. He said, if this man were a prophet, he would know who is touching him and what kind of woman she is. And then he stated, she is a sinner. Our Lord Jesus Christ, who knew whatever in his heart, said to Simon, and this is also in the beginning, St. Luke did not mention his name, but the Lord addressed him with his name. At the beginning said, a Pharisee invited him. Then the Lord addressed him, Simon, I have something to tell you. And Simon said, teacher, tell it. And the Lord gave him a wonderful parable. There was a certain money lender give some money to some people who are in need. One, he gave him 500 dinars and the other 50. And then the Lord go in on and he said to him, both of them, they cannot repay back, so he forgive them both. And then he asked Simon, Simon, what do you think? Which one will love him more? And Simon gave the right answer. He said, I suppose, the one who had the bigger debt forgiven. And our Lord Jesus Christ looked at him and said, you have judged correctly. So here our Lord Jesus Christ revealed to him that he knew what is in his heart. To answer his doubt, if he is a prophet, he will know what kind of woman she is, a sinner. He would like to tell him, I know who you are, what is in your heart. I know who is she and what is in her heart. But the most important, both of you are sinners. Both of you are short to do God's will. But the most important, the one who repent and the other, which is Simon, he did not repent or even he didn't feel that he need to repent. This is what we call self-righteous. Think that he is pioneer, he's the best, he's one of the Pharisees. He can invite our Lord Jesus Christ in his home. So he judged her and did not judge himself. This is the Lord give him this parable. And he took from his answer and he said, yes, correctly, your answer is correct. And this is exactly what is the situation. And then the Lord look to the woman and they spoke with Simon. And I was very touched that when you see St. Luke as a physician, as artist or iconographer, and as historian, recorded for us everything in a very unique way. He looked at Simon and he looked to the woman and talked to Simon. Said, Simon, you judge this woman, you judge me, and you did not judge yourself. Let me make some kind of comparison between you and the woman you judge. I enter your house, and you give me no water. The custom is if you have a guest at that time, and they kept it for many, many years in the monasteries, you wash his feet with water. Even with water, Simon, you did not give it to me. While she, the one whom you judge, wash my feet with her tears. And you know the difference in value between water and tears. You did not wipe my feet because you did not wash it with water, but she wiped it my feet with her hair. And you know what is the value of the hair of the woman? It is hair crown. The hair of the woman is hair crown. So imagine what she did to express her sincerity of repentance. You did not put oil in my head, but she put a very expensive perfume. What do you think? I told you through the parable. She loved more, and this is why the Lord forgave her more. The one who loves little, he will receive little. So here is a wonderful story. Simon failed, but the woman passed the exam. The woman had many sins, but now they are forgiven, while Simon's sins are retained. And then our Lord Jesus Christ looked to the woman, and he did not look again to Simon or talk to him. And then he said to her, "Your faith has saved you. Go in peace." Your faith have saved you. Go in peace. And here is a wonderful and very important question. What is her faith that saved her? And the answer, this woman believed that if she came to our Lord Jesus Christ as a repent sinner, he will never send her away. He will accept her. This is her belief. Because she insists to offer her repentance. And she knew 100% that he would never send her away or rejected her. Because the reason that she went to the house, because she heard a lot about our Lord Jesus Christ. And if she have doubt that maybe he would accept me, maybe not, she may go and meet him privately, so nobody will see her around. But she entered the Simon's house without any invitation, in front of everyone who gathered around our Lord Jesus Christ inside Simon's house. And she did all what we mentioned in a very unique way, sincerely way. She did not care what are the people going to say about her. But she inside, and this is what the Lord said, "Your faith has saved you," know that he will accept her. And this is exactly what happened. Wonderful story. Many lessons we can learn it from these stories. I will mention five of them. Number one, the first lesson is that our Lord Jesus Christ came to seek and to save all the people. God so loved the world, so that he gave his only begotten Son, so that everyone who believed in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. He said, "I came to call sinners, not righteous for repentance." So he came to save everyone. Sinner who decided to repent and ask for forgiveness. The second lesson, that our Lord Jesus Christ loved the sinners. Of course, he did not love sins itself. That's why he said, "Don't sin." That's why he gave us the commandments. But he loved the sinners. And he loved them, and we all sinners, as the Bible said, St. John said, no one is without sin, even though his or her life a single day on earth. And St. John continued and said, if we say that we are without sin, we make him liars. Him, capital H. So we're all sinners. And love God all, us, love us all, unconditional love. But sinner to repent, not sinner to continue to do their sins. or to do our sins. So our Lord Jesus Christ loved the sinners, but he did not love the sins itself, and he called us to repent, and he guaranteed and promised he will accept our repentance. The third lesson of the gospel today, that our Lord Jesus Christ came to save the sinners, not to condemn them or to condemn the us. You remember the other woman and the gospel yesterday in the gospel was about her. The woman that they caught her while she sinned, and they would like to stone her. And our Lord Jesus Christ said, if anyone without sin, let him stone her first. And then he started to write down their sins on the ground. Lest someone will assume, like the Pharisees, he is not with his sin, and then he will stone her. Everyone with his stone crossed by our Lord Jesus Christ, till the Lord write certain sin, yani he knew this is the most sin struggle, or at least he practiced. So he looked at it and then passed away. And our Lord Jesus Christ raised his face and said, no one condemned you, woman? She said, no. Then he said to her, neither I do I condemn you. Go your way and sin no more. This is the key. Go your way and sin no more. So he loved the sinners, but he will say to all of us as a sinners, sin no more. This is the third lesson, that our Lord Jesus Christ came to save the sinners and not to condemn them or us. The fourth lesson, it is for those who did not liken the sinful woman in their life, like the Pharisees or any other people who have the chance to come to the church, to repent, ask for God's forgiveness, and they did not. We'll say to them or to us, this lesson for all of us, come, resemble, learn from this woman, grab the chance, offer your repentance, regret your sins, promise not to sin anymore. To this lesson, because you may have a chance today, or may have a chance today to repent, the Lord in the church, he is in the altar, he is everywhere, but we did not grab the chance. We may say, maybe next week, maybe I will wait until the end of the year, maybe in my birthday, maybe, and then time go on until we lose our salvation. We have to learn today from this woman. She grabbed the chance, although nobody invited her, neither Simon nor his household in his house, but she grabbed it since she heard that he is in the house of Simon, she went and repented. Grab the chance. The fifth lesson, and the most important one, as well as we have to learn and to liken with the sinful woman, to repent and we go in peace as the Lord said to her, we have also to follow the steps of our Lord Jesus Christ, not the view of Simon. Here I would like to compare between the Lord Jesus and Simon. In regard to the sin and the sinners, two different views. And we should, as a Christian, as a follower of our Lord Jesus Christ, follow his steps. Because he said he bought for us a great example to be followed. What is Simon's view about sin and the sinners? For Simon want to keep sinners out, while Jesus went out to sinners. I will repeat this. Simon wanted to keep sinners out, while Jesus went out for the sinner, like he went to the Samaritan woman. Simon looked at sin as a disease and the sinners as a sick people. And he said, there is no cure. The best way to save us from the sinners, to let them out. Ayaduna, to let them out. Because this is uncured disease. He assumed that he is the best self-righteous, as I said. While our Jesus Christ is the cure itself for the sin and for the sinners. And as I said, he said, I came not to invite righteous for repentance, but sinners to repent. The heaven rejoices with one sinners repent more than 99 don't need for repentance. And this is the most important lesson of this great story. We have to follow our Lord Jesus Christ in dealing with sin and the sinners. Sinners are sick people. We are sinners. But the cure is our Lord Jesus Christ. This is not a solution that you isolate the sinners, or you hate them, or send them out, or you say, don't touch me, or don't touch Jesus. But the best way to accept them as our Lord Jesus Christ accepted them. We are all sinners, as I said. One of our great saints said, the church is like hospital and not like a court of law. I will repeat it. The church is like hospital and not like a court of law. You are not here to judge those who come to the church. You be very funny. Everyone say, oh, the Egyptian. Oh, the newcomers. Oh, the people who did so and so. Everyone condemned the other. We didn't examine himself or herself how they behave in the church or outside the church, like Simon's and like this woman. And sometimes we take the view of Simon, send them away, avoid them. This is not the right way. We are sinners. The church open for everyone. It is like hospital. It is not like court of law. But of course, we are not going to allow the sinners to continue in their sins. Sinners to repent. Sinners to ask for forgiveness. But at least they have to take a chance. We have to give a chance. They have to give us a chance. We are sinners. We are not much better. No one without sin. Even though if his or her single, if his or her life is a single day on earth. We have to resemble our Lord Jesus Christ, who accepted the sinners, who came and repent, ask for forgiveness. Glory be to God forever and ever.